Welcome each and every one of you to episode number 19 of my challenge run through Dark Souls 3. I have to apologize at this point because once again I lost some gameplay footage, but it's not too bad actually. So what I did was I opened the path to the boss. And right now, where you might wonder where I'm going, I'm going where I opened up the path for the boss, because you don't know that yet. Because what I'm going to do now is like part of the gameplay footage that was lost. I went down here and traveled through this area, killing enemies and collecting items, and I found the armor of the knight we fought earlier, that really hard guy. That was a really tough fight. In the corner in that direction. Also, we learned that these guys are that we did in the last episode already. So we learned that these guys are really hard. Oh shit! And also, I'm going to go there right now. There was a lever. I pulled that lever, and by pulling that, I actually released. Oh, what was that? That looked weird. Well, by pulling the lever, I opened up a secret passage up there, which led to the boss fight, and I'm actually really sorry, because now I'm going to recap what happened the first time I went into the boss room, because there was a little bit of dialogue. The boss fight happens up there, where we met those NPCs, especially you remember the one that wanted us to go back into the main game, I guess. Well, when we opened up the path was here, in that direction. She just followed us down there. But first of all, we found like a huge guy with a chalice or something like that in front of him, and he was talking about that he needs his whip and that he needs more blood and stuff. And then the woman comes down, and he asks also for the woman, and then she comes down and the boss fight begins. She was the first part of the boss fight we had down there. And it took me like 1.5 hours to beat that boss. So therefore, from this moment on, this episode will be similar to episode number 25 of my run through Bloodborne, where I just cut together the highlights of all my tries at the boss fight to make the one boss fight fit in one episode. So I'm really sorry that I lost some footage, especially that I lost the first time I encountered the boss, and yeah, I hope you enjoy it. Have fun. So actually, now that I unsolved the mystery of the invisibility attack, I really would like her to do more of the invisibility stuff, as that's so easy to. Okay, she's jumping. She landed there. Okay. You know, sometimes her just completely usual attacks catch me off guard so hard, because I really expect some, like, big move. So I got her. This time I have 4 healing left. I think I wanna focus that guy down. But I have to be careful though, as she uses this field which stacks up frostbite. There. I've beaten the boss halfway through so far. Okay, now she also does the invisible stuff. Not good at all. Oh, she casts healing. That's not good. So I have to keep an eye on her as she starts to heal this enemy, this boss. Man, this boss fight would be amazing if the enemies were a little bit harder, but they could hit each other. So I have no more healing left, but the guy is almost down. Oh shit, I'm dead. I live. I got him, and I'm dead. So. I got a Titanite slap, so did I won the fight now? I guess I haven't won the fight, but I'm pretty sure I got a Titanite slap, didn't I? Yeah, I got a Titanite slap. That's like Titanite slaps are used to get the last level of on your weapon, so that's quite nice, but okay, apparently I have to beat the boss again. Okay, invisibility, I love it when she does that. Okay, I think she's done though. But of course, I just lost her. And am I dead?
Return from whence thou camest.
Fuck it. So what are you doing? At long range she only can do invisibility or... Oh shit, I think I'm dead.
Return from yeah, whence again. Thou camest.
Okay. Oh shit. She goes very far with that one. Oh, shit. What the fuck? I mean,
return
sometimes I really don't get the
camest.
Invisible. Punishable attack? Punishable attack? No, oh, I just dodged a little bit too late. Come on, do something. There she is. Okay, that was so weird. I really don't like it sometimes how this works. So now she's like here. Nope, she isn't. Oh, there she is. So this time it worked. So where did she went now? I couldn't see it because it was too bright. There she is. So, we got that. Can we kill that guy now without getting hit once? Or at least without need to heal up at all. Oh, and that's like the best start we could do for that. And now we are frostbitten and we are dead. So,
thou art the Lord of Londor, and have thine own subjects okay, to guide.
This try was so fucking bad. I really want to be able to do the first phase without any big trouble. So do your stuff. I'm ready to dodge. Okay. Punishable? Yes. I really like that attack because it's extremely easy to avoid. I think it's a little bit like with Ludwig in Bloodborne, which I struggled a lot with when I encountered him, where the first phase is kind of harder, for me at least, but the difficulty lies in transition between the first and the second phase fast. So there she is. That's it. Oh shit. There she was.
Leave us be.
And there, oh shit. I'm really not sure. Maybe I can kill her in the second phase completely, so she doesn't even distract me anymore while I'm fighting with the guy. But I'm not sure about that. I almost got him one time, so I guess I'm sticking to my strategy just to focus him down. I also lost my about 10,000 souls just now. That's not too much. Not too much of a big deal. So now she's there. What are you doing now? That attack, I like it. So where did she went now? That's not good. So, with this attack, I think the best way to deal with it is just to walk slightly away from her. There she is. Got her. And I only used one healing so far, so the best try we had so far. Oh shit. There she goes in. You know, that would be an extremely amazing gimmick for this boss fight if these two guys could hit each other, because he apparently uses fire and she uses ice, and the attacks are like, the way he wields his stuff is like, it feels like it's meant to be able to make him hit someone else than just you. But, and at the same time, also the way she makes those... also the way she makes her ice stuff also feels like it's meant to be able to make her hit him with it. Oh shit, I think she is healing him. And she's just inside of him. Super amazing. I can't hit her because she's inside of him. And I...
Leave us be.
Oh shit. I thought I could do like a special attack against him, but apparently I could. Wow, that was extremely bullshit right now. She was just inside of him, so I couldn't stop her from healing him. Oh shit, that attack. I always forget about that one, and I'm dead. There she is. Got her. I didn't got hit even once. So that's nice. I think I just missed him, which is super stupid. So, nope. Not what I want you to do at all. That is a new attack. Not good. She should try to heal him any moment now. Yeah, there she goes. I'm going to stop her as fast as possible. But apparently I survived the hit, and I think there are some things I can still survive. I got him. Okay, the boss fight keeps on.
Leave us be, Ashen One.
What the fuck?
The Lord of Londor, and have thine own subjects.
Okay, she was extremely close just now.
Leave us be, Ashen One.
It's too bright here. I can't see where she landed. You know what? I think I'm going to use a homeward bone.
Return from
I just die.
Oh,
I just die. Yeah, that's maybe way smarter. Okay.
Return okay. From whence thou camest.
I just was still on the homeward bone and didn't thought about that. Oh no. Where did she went? It was too bright, I couldn't see it. There she was.
Return and I'm dead. Whence thou.
So this time I'm trying to kill her. I'm trying to go on her. I also have the feeling that she is not as strong as she is in the first phase. But apparently she's enough to fuck me up pretty badly right now. Okay, apparently I can backstab her and that fucked me up because I was stuck in the animation until he already channeled his fire around me.
Leave us be,
and I'm dead. So
the Lord of Londor. And have thine own subjects.
I actually think it is a good idea to focus her down first. At least it is a good idea if she really takes damage. I'm not sure about that yet, but yeah, we'll see about that. Then we have episode 19, where we just flat out die against this boss again and again. You know what? I just want to die now. But no. No. Okay.
Return from whence thou camest.
She goes in her stance and then is doing. Oh, shit, no. Come on, get here. Okay, I think I deal. If I hit her, I deal just damage to him. So it doesn't matter. And I have to go through three phases. Whew. I actually considered way easier to go for him. Even though then some stuff like that can happen. I might just try to focus him down again. I mean, I went way better with that tactic so far. Okay. Oh, I take damage if I stand too close to her. Okay. Whew. Okay, she just keeps comboing. And that is a new grab attack. I think I'm dead. No, the grab attack still doesn't insta-kill me.
Leave us be,
okay.
Ashen One. Thou art the Lord of Lord.
And he's doing that again. I think, yeah, I just could have done a special attack against him. So, is she doing the leaping attack now again? Yeah. Oh shit. Yeah, you have to know what you're doing. You have to know what her moves do and how to punish them. Like, this one is extremely easy to punish.
Leave us be.
Ah.
Return from whence thou camest.
Shit. Oh, you can backstep her while she's in that animation.
Leave us be, Ashen One.
Okay, that was stupid.
Leave us be.
Oh, what the fuck?
Thou art.
Oh, shit. And there she was again, fucking me up. She's ruining my day.
Leave us be, Ashen One.
Wow. Thou art. He is extremely slow and clunky, and she doesn't do too much in the second phase. So it is a little bit like, instead of having two really hard enemies, They just made two extremely weak enemies, but added a third phase in which one of them just goes extremely crazy again for the last attempt. So instead of that, I would have liked to have rather extremely strong hard fight with like the second phase, and then it is there, and that's it. So I really don't like the decision they made there by making this their third phase. So, but instead, the second phase isn't really hard, but it is annoying. Because you just have to always look out for the frost ground, and you always have to keep an eye on her, and that's not difficult. It's just annoying. The another
leave
thing. Ah, shit.
Leave us be, Ashen One.
I just got insta killed. It feels like the first phase is not like a boss fight, but more like just a fight against a strong usual enemy. And the second phase, it feels so weird, but because the difficulty in this boss fight doesn't lie in anything else than the fact that if she gets too close to you while you're fighting him, you're basically fucked. Yeah. So I guess I figured this phase out now. I now kinda know how to punish stuff. So I guess that was it. If there isn't a fourth phase, yeah. That is it. Soul of Sister Frieda. Short conclusion, what I think about this boss. I don't like it. I think they have just wasted so much potential. They could have done it in so many different cool ways. But what they did was they just dished out three disappointing bosses. And the difficulty lies in staying concentrated through all the three phases and nothing else. That wasn't fun at all. I mean, yeah, the bosses got some stretches, but in the end, the first phase feels like a little bit stronger enemy. The second phase is like extremely random. The difficulty level depends on what Frieda is trying to do. If she's staying close to you, it's getting ridiculously annoying and fucked up. If she keeps staying away, it's extremely easy. And also, she sometimes does super bullshit move and starts to heal him while she is inside of him, which is completely bullshit. And the third phase is like, yeah, it is a boss, and it feels like a boss fight. But it is extremely you have to wait so much. You always have to wait for her to do the punishable moves, because she doesn't get too many of them. And yeah, in the end, even the third phase is kinda easy when you figured out how to punish her, which moves you can punish, and yeah, I mean, the difficulty lies completely in the fact that you have to be focused through three phases, and every time you encounter the phases the first time, you are most likely going to die because you haven't seen it before, so you don't know what you're expecting, and then it is like, oh yeah, you died two or three times against the first phase, now you figured it out. Now you can kill the first phase pretty easy. Get to the second phase. Have to die two or three times against the second phase to find out what works against that. Or maybe a little bit more often, because after you died against the second phase, you have to do the first phase again. And then when you get to the second phase, you just have to remember, how did I die last time? Then you die again like you did last time. And yeah, it's just so extremely annoying. And then you have like three parts of that. I mean, you get to the third phase, and if you die instantly from the first move, you have to go through the first and the second phase, staying focused. You can't allow any mistakes, and even if you just go through the first and the second phase easy, you reach the third phase again and might just die against the same move again, because at that time you just forgot how you died last time. That's like not a difficulty I like, so yeah, a little bit rant from me for From Software here. I mean, I'm a huge fan of the games, but this boss fight, I don't like it. I really don't like it. Anyways, I'm pretty happy that have beaten it now, and yeah. See you guys in the next episode. Goodbye.